Hebrews chapter 10 verse 21. And having an high priest over the house of God. 22. Let us draw near with a full heart and full assurance of faith, having our hearts sprinkled from an evil conscience and our bodies washed with pure water. Proceed. Let us hold fast the profession of our faith without wavering, for he is faithful that promised. Hallelujah. 24. Let us consider one another to provoke unto love and to good works. 25. Not forsaking the assembly of ourselves together, as the manner of some is, but exhorting one another, and so much the more as you see the day approaching. I'd like to have this last one in Amplified. Hebrews chapter 10, verse 25. In Amplified. Listen to it. Not forsaking or neglecting to assemble together as believers, as is the habit of some people. As is what? That means there's people doing it. But admonishing, warning, urging, and encouraging one another, and all the more faithfully as you see the day approaching. The Lord bless the reading of his word in Jesus. The scripture we read is the word of God, but not for God. Whenever the word of God comes, it is not coming for God, but from God. If the word of God is coming from God, it is not coming to God, it is coming to a people that are the people of God. In 2 Timothy 3 verse 16 says, all scripture is given by the inspiration of what? God. And is profitable for doctrine, reproof. That's 2 Timothy 3:16. For direction, for instruction, in righteousness. So whenever the word of God is coming for, it is coming for the people of God for their benefit. word do not benefit God. God's word only challenges God. Am I speaking to somebody? Whenever God speaks or gives His word, He expects that man should hear and obey it. If the word is demanding on man, then man is expected to challenge God with the word. If the word of God has placed a demand on a life, you either respond to it or challenge God with it. That is where you get the profit. You get the reproof. You get the correction. You get instruction. And all these are done in righteousness. And the scripture we read in Hebrews 10 verse 21 began with an introduction that in every house of God there is a priest. Not just a priest, a high priest. And a high priest is there found in the house of God, over the house of God. This is not in heaven. He's talking about a high priest over the house of God. And the house of God is right here. Am I speaking to somebody? Am I speaking to someone? The house of God is talking about the tabernacle of God that is with man. So wherever you find people gathered and they are praying, it is the house of God. And in such house of God, there is always a high priest. And he's saying, because we have a high priest in the house, because of a high priest, because we have a leader, let us do what? Give me the scripture. Let us do what? Come closer. And your invitation has a condition. Draw it nearer. Coming, but he said, come with a true heart. A true heart. If I begin to talk about this alone, the service we shall have a second service running
up.
Just that true heart. There is an invitation here to attend service on Sunday or Wednesday or any day they are gathering in church. This is an invitation. He said, go and pray. Go and worship. But you are going there as you are getting closer to the door of the church. Make sure you are entering the door with a true heart. It could be that you have a lifestyle that people in your neighborhood are complaining about. It could be that people know you, that you are always getting angry. He says, when you approach the door of the tabernacle, where there is a high priest,
that you have a change of heart. Make sure that the heart you are entering with is a true heart. Am I speaking to somebody already? Coming to church with a true heart. If I will place a meter in our hearts now, will it read true? Why are you here? That could be the topic of my message. I have different topic coming into my heart. But I'm speaking on holding fast your profession. I'm speaking on what? Holding fast your what? Profession. And the message of vision almost made me ask, why are you here? True hearts. There are people we have encountered in church who are no longer in church. Of course, we now know why they came. They got one breakthrough and they went by. They got one miracle and they went by. Some came to learn how you are, how you do your deeds, and they went by. Why are you here? He says, come with a true heart. Are you sure you are here to serve God? Are you sure you are here to bless the Lord? Are you sure you are here to give God praise? Are you sure you are here to praise and to give God praise? Are you sure you are not here just for the miracle you will get? Are you sure you are not here just for the healing you will get? Are you sure you are not here just for the breakthrough you need? And then you went by. Such a message should come now. Because I want to know how many we are. Am I allowed to preach like this? You find a lot of reasons why people come to church. Many a times, you only know it after things have get better. That is when you begin to know who is with you. And you ask questions like, so all these years, this is your true color. May God help us in Jesus. Come and draw near with a true heart in full assurance of faith. That is also a topic of its own. The church of God is filled these days with people who come and they are expecting a magic. He says, come with a true heart in full assurance of faith. Church, listen to me. If you come before God without faith, I am sorry to disappoint you. Nothing will happen around your life. But you are coming into His presence with faith and assurance that if He did it before, He can do it again. If He messed my brother, He can bless me again. If He delivered Paul and Silas, He can deliver me. If He blessed Abraham, He can bless me again. That is faith, man. You carry it with that assurance in your heart. Of doing miracles.
and you're waiting for your miracle. That is faith, sister.
Amen.
Say, Dronia. With full assurance of faith. The assurance of your faith must be full. When faith is full, it means there is no doubt. There is no space for doubt. I am glad to tell you today, there is no space of doubt in my heart that God is about to bless somebody here. That God is about to heal somebody. That God is about to lift somebody here. I know it just like I know my bank hand. I have tried him. I have tested him. He doesn't fail. He never fails. So my assurance is full. Even when the wind blows and the storms rise, it doesn't mean you don't have the faith. It is more reason to discover the faith. Am I speaking to somebody? I know somebody might be questioning in their heart. Why is this trouble happening? Why was I sick in the first place? Why did even it happen? Listen to me. I have come with good news to tell you. God do not shelter you from the storm, but God shelters you in the storm. Am I speaking to somebody? God may not shelter you from the wind, but God can shelter you in the wind. God may not preserve you from the calamity, but right in the midst of it, God can preserve you. In other words, what I'm trying to say is this: even if the flood was not stopped from coming, the flood cannot take your feet off the shore. Do I speak to somebody? Even if the rain was not stopped from falling, the rain was not going to swallow you. But the same God of yesterday is the same today, is the same forever. If he did not stop the children of Israel from meeting the Red Sea, but he made the way right in the sea, God has not stopped the problem from visiting you. Listen to me. The reason he did not stop it is because he has a plan to make a way through the problem. Am I speaking to somebody? Jump on your face and say, God will surely make a way in the storm. If you have one,
yes, Lord.
Full assurance of faith. When I have this knowledge, my heart sprinkled from evil conscience. I don't want to talk about that long. The church of God needs to realize that before God does anything he has to do, there is what he calls confidence check. After he's done with confidence check, he has to do a sustainability check. Are you listening to me? Are you listening to me? He will do a confidence check, then he will do sustainability check. And then he will do a pride check.
Okay.
before he blesses, before he delivers, before he releases, before he opens a door, he does this by mountains. And many a times, confidence check is there. You're confident that God must bless you. Many a times, sustainability check is there. You know you can sustain the blessing of God. You know you will not lose the husband when God gives you the husband. You know from experience, you know you can sustain that miracle. But we have touch and people fail. It's the pride check.
Amalala.
Evil conscience.
In the world's envy.
God, I need money. What for?
Zachi.
Myself.
Zange.
Selfishness.
Where that is that we can wake up.
Pride check, selfishness check in one basket.
Lord, I need
this. What for?
Chachi.
Selfishness. Me. This is where people fail. And this is where the angels take back the blessing. And if I bless this one, this one
oh no,
will not even come near the church. If I visit this one with my grace, this one will not see road to pass. Are you understanding me? There is a check that goes on. And when God finds that by blessing you, Sister Janet will not pass your same road. And yet, he has checked Sister Janet. She does not have selfishness. She passed the mark of selfishness, but she has not developed confidence to
you.
Are you following me? God will stop your own blessing. I will be waiting until Sister Janet develops the confidence so that at the same time you can also pass the selfishness test. Having our heart sprinkled from an evil conscience. It is your heart. But it has to be pure before blessings will come. Are somebody getting me? The reason people are not blessed, it's not because they have not given. It's not because they have not prayed. It's not because they have not fasted. It's not because the duty of blessing will not be duty for them. No! It is because there is an evil conscience towards another that God has not even blessed. As children of God, you must be careful to check how you react when your neighbor announces a miracle. Very, very crucial. Christianity and its blessing is interwoven. Are you understanding? It's interwoven. Christianity and blessing are interwoven. Am I speaking to somebody? For the reason of one blessing, it can happen to another. That is what the Bible says. Jesus is the spirit of prophecy. Because when you testify about what Jesus has done, it is a prophecy to me. And I collect it, I connect to it. I testify of what Jesus has done. It is a prophecy to Mr. C. As this one collects it, spread from this angle to the other angle and spread to the angle. That is why when there is a problem here, there is an evil conscience here, the blessing cannot pass through, because there is a connection from here to here. The individual is blessed, it will transfer here, but because the blessing has reached here and there is a selfishness check now, and selfishness is found here, the blessing stops here, and therefore another person is deprived of the blessing that should flow. Am I speaking to somebody? It is time for the church to arise, take a seat, and wake up and check yourself. The blessing of my brother, will I celebrate it? That my brother is succeeding, will I celebrate it? That my sister is doing well, will guarantee your own grace to us. Somebody say yes.
I don't know if I'm communicating to somebody. How can our heart worship your evil?
I said 20 minutes, I'm already taking over. I'm about to close. This message is not finished. We are still on one verse. Are you
understanding?
We're still on one. I think I have to take it for a series. From evil conscious. And when the heart is done with, I pray for somebody today, your heart will pass the selfishness check. I declare you shall be cleansed from every evil conscience. In the name of Jesus, you will no longer feel offended at somebody's blessing. You will no longer feel offended at somebody's progress. We will celebrate testimonies. We will celebrate somebody's miracle. And that is how your miracle will come in the name of Jesus. I should be excited that my brother is leading prayer well. Am I
saying
something? I should be happy that there is somebody who is doing what I am not doing well. I think this is time for utility check. The contents of the heart. It's time to set it right. The church of God will connect to blessing when we set this right. Conscience. Do you know the simple things like your child is playing with other children and the child comes out, the other child comes out with gorillas? Mommy, I got my gorillas. I have my gorillas. I have my gorillas. And the other child runs to the mother. You see, Esther has got gorillas. They have got gorillas for Esther. And his mother said, gorilla is not good. It's not good. It will give you stomach ache. It will pot you. The one she has is not good. Don't eat. That's common act of normal thing.
Huh?
Can be an evil conscience. As the mother. Am I speaking to somebody? Why are you telling the child that gorillas is not good? Why are you trying to use condemnation to save yourself from expense? If you don't have it, tell the child, mommy does not have money now. Mommy will buy you many gorillas as you want when I go to the market and I get money. Is that better? Why are you
discrediting another family's name. Just because you want to save your
own.
Are you understanding that? A simple life is an example. Celebrate another person's success. Between the devil and God, who is in charge? Who is in charge? Who is in charge? Evil conscience. It's right in the church. Just make a mistake. Buy a car. When they have sacked you from work, they know you have been sacked from work. You buy a car. I told you that they belong to something. Where is he getting the money?
For your center.
Why the devil is fighting grace is because the devil always wants people of grace to be like him. The devil is using people who are wretched, who have not seen what you are seeing, because they want you to remain like them.
Look
outside, but no more. I say no more. No more. The name of Jesus. Do you know that many of the trouble you are facing is sponsored by people who don't like you? It might not be coming directly from them, but they are feeding the people who love you. It is, if you trust it, it is a sponsorship of evil conscience. My brother, and I have an evil conscience. I might not talk to him directly because he will pour it in my face. You are wicked, you are evil, you have an evil conscience against me. So I will go to my mother. Mama, have you seen this one has not sent sugar to you for a whole year? Brother Matthew has not said anything. Me and he are struggling. He cannot help me. Are you understanding this? Never have I picked the phone and talked to Brother Matthew. Please, I need you to help me with 200K. But I'm going to mother. There is no help. So what is that one doing in Kampala? Are you understanding evil conscience now? It is passing through with the pretense of love. You trust it. It is what?
Evil
conscience. He says, having our hearts. When you have it
purged.
And our body is washed with pure water. That one alone, if I come there, all of us will go to swimming pool. If I want to dwell here, we will go to a dating competition. God is washed with pure water. That is not a sprinkling there.
I was even hanging up some money.
That is what? Blood and sprinkling. As I try to run, give me 23. And let us hold fast the profession of our faith. Somebody say hallelujah. Let us hold fast the profession of our faith. Every child of God has got an assignment in the house of God. Are you an usher? Are you a counselor? Are you a member? That is your profession. Hold fast. Are you a prayer warrior? Do you know how to encourage people? Hold in what?
Fast.
Are you a giver? That is your ministry. Hold it what? profession without, you know what is going
on?
You change this color today, tomorrow you change this color. Change this color tomorrow, you do what? Change this color. If I hear a child of God saying, by the time I am done with you, you are not my joker. I ran away from you. That is why from the first he says, let your heart be a true heart. So that if you come with another type of heart, we are knowing what it is. But if you are coming into the house with a true heart, make sure it stays true. There are people in the house of God, and I pray you are not like that. Problems define your stand. When there are issues in church, that is when you have to know who is really a child of God or not. They fall away. Those are the times the Bible says they are wavering. The Bible says a house that is built on a rock, the test of it is rain, the test of it is storm. How can we know you are standing on a rock if rain does not come? So if you are in church expecting that you will not get offended, sorry for you. If you are in church thinking that somebody will not talk to you badly, sorry for you. If you are in church thinking that somebody will not overlook you, sorry for you. Because the only way we shall know that you are built on a rock is when the flood comes. When the rain comes. When the wind beats. And you are standing. Then you say, this one is built on a rock. Is there anybody here that is built on a rock? There are many men who are built on a rock. Then it does not matter what comes around you. It does not matter who offends you. He says without wavering. I like the last part. For he is faithful that promised. Let us hold fast. Yes, I know there are many churches. Why did they not show you before? Why did they allow you test of the true power? Why did they allow you test of the anointing? Why did they allow you test of the joy that can be found in God? And now, they want you to become a vagabond. No way! I'm talking to you in present or in advance. But there are many who will rise up and tell you that church is wicked. They will tell you that church is witchcraft. That church is not right. This message is for you then. Is somebody hearing me? Listen to me. For he is faithful. That promised. I am the Lord, I change it not. That is a promise. Therefore, ye sons of Jacob are not consumed. The God is not a liar that he should lie. Am I speaking to somebody? So what he says, will bring it to pass. Has he said it and has he not performed it? is on the process.
Chiri mukubo chicha.
I have not called these sons of Jacob to seek me in
vain.
He said, he that called me is faithful. He is faithful. He knows you're going out, he knows you're coming in. And your matter is in his hand. And he's still at work for you. If he says he is faithful, he is faithful. Oh, hallelujah, he is faithful. He is faithful. It doesn't matter what is happening. It doesn't matter what is not there yet. He is faithful if he says he is faithful. He is faithful if he says he is faithful. He said, he that cometh to God must first of all believe that he is. And that he is a rewarder of them that diligently seek him. When you came to him, what did they tell you? Did they tell you that it's going to happen like a magic? The one who told you that lied to you. God is not in a hurry when it comes to his children. He takes them step by step. That you are not there yet does not mean you will not get there. It is on a journey. And I know he that called us will take us to our destination. My friend, listen to me. Somewhere. You are just a moving miracle. Looking to your finished product. Your miracle is ahead. Your destiny is ahead. Your breakthrough is ahead. Your worst days are behind you. Your best days are ahead of you. If God has called you for, he will bring you to it. I prophesy to somebody here. The journey he started, he will finish it. Has he said it? Has he not come to pass? We serve a faithful God. We serve a living God. He is a Yam that I am. He is the ancient of days. He is still at work in your life. He is a miracle worker.